got together and decided we should have a central jazz once every year. So I'm a little chagrined, but I actually have a program with 7 tunes, so hopefully you won't fall asleep on us. They're a pretty exciting band, and they learn music really fast, but we'll get going and I won't talk very much. This first tune is by Duke Ellington. It's part of a larger suite of music called Such Sweet Thunder, and this is the title track of that, but it's basically Ellington's Shakespearean suite. And there's only one little soul with it, and Ben Robinson's gonna play it. And for those of you who are literary specialists, this is where Othello is trying to woo Desdemona. Trumpets, the pep band, I call them the three wise men. Next tune we're going to play is a wonderful arrangement by Mike Tomorrow, who's at Duquesne University now and was for many years writing for the military bands in D.C. This is Gil Evans, Miles Davis collaboration called Boplicity. We know bop is a very fast music, but there was sort of a response to that in the late 40s and early 50s. Kind of called the West Coast or Cool School, and Boplicity, which sounds like simplified bebop, was one of the famous tunes on an album that Miles recorded called Birth of the Cool, which spanned 1949 to 51. The original instrumentation was alto sax, barry sax, trumpet, trombone, French horn, and tuba. Six horns and three rhythm. And Mike sort of figured out a way to use conventional instrumentation so we can enjoy this music. For those of you who are really history buffs, it really started a few years earlier when Gil Evans was writing for Claude Thornhill's orchestra, and his band actually had a French horn and a tuba in it, and they were trying to figure out how few instruments could we get this same sound, and they eventually chose a non-net for it. So we're gonna feature baritone sax, trumpet, and piano on this, okay? Bop-pussity. Jason Marcellus. So Joshua said just a minute ago when he introduced me, I am part of a group of musicians that are running a program in Savannah, Georgia called Swing Central. It's sort of a southern version of Essentially Ellington. And we have a couple North Carolina groups coming down for the first time this late March and early April. So I'm very excited about that. Each year we commission a chart, and we're going to play you the commission chart this year, which is written by Jason Marcellus, the younger drummer brother of Winton and Branford. It's called In the House, In the Pocket. And is one of the early tunes he sort of wrote when he was in high school. And it kind of explores the blues, and a little bit of the New Orleans style of drumming, which is kind of a shonk tonk tonk doom ding doom ding ding doom boom ba. That last beat four is called the big beat. I guess I'll introduce the soloists now because there's a pack of them. We got a little group at the front. Will be Ben Robinson and Jack Trathan and Eric Waugh. Then we're going to hear Aaron Albright on guitar, Jacob Boss on trumpet, and Griffin Ross on tenor sax. What? Your saxophone is broken? Oh. Is there a berry in the house? That's probably the first time in the history of the world that those words have been spoken. Can you not play? Well, then get up and go fix it. Yeah. We just need to take a little short break here, and if somebody in the A band or the middle school band has a Barry sax, we will pay you top dollar.
Thank you.
hopefully you'll be able to hear me. I was telling the students earlier today, there's a Duke Ellington archives at the Historical Museum at the Smithsonian. And you go in there and you ask to look at the music, you have to put on the white gloves and they bring out a box and you open it up. And what I wanted the students to realize was, I never saw on a part that said first alto, second alto, first tenor, second tenor. It would say Rab, Paul, Cootie, Cat, Ray. And the reason I wanted to tell them that was, after living with these guys and getting, I told them, I said, we'll play today's concert, we'll get on the bus and we'll drive to Dayton, Ohio, and we'll play one tomorrow. And we'll get on the bus and we'll drive to Detroit and play one tomorrow. Do that for 27 years. Duke Ellington doesn't have to open the textbook to say the alto can play from this note to this note. He says, that's not really the case with my guy. He can do three notes higher and two notes lower or whatever. So it's a very personalized way of writing music for people. And so one of his all-time great solos, particularly when he wanted to bring out something romantic or sensuous, was a little 5'3" saxophonist from Boston named Johnny Hodges. So we found a 5'3" guy. From just this other side of Hillsboro, which, believe it or not, Billy Strayhorn's grandmother lived in Hillsboro. So he's got a connection to the Ellington thing. Here's our Johnny Hodges, Eric Waugh, playing one of the movements of the 9-movement Far East Suite that Ellington wrote between 63 and 66. Hang on. Thank you. Thank you so much. How about another hand for Eric? That's a lot of nuance for such a young person. Good for him. This next piece is written by Alan Baylock, who knows, may be the Sammy Nestico of this generation. What I mean by that is when I was in college, Sammy Nestico was one of the main writers for Count Basie, and jazz education was much more in its infant stages, and we just relished having Kendor Music publish those charts for us to play. And now we've got this young man who's heading the jazz program, leading the famous 1 o'clock band at North Texas, Alan Baylock. Prior to that, he was also in Washington, D.C., writing for the Airmen and Note and other groups. But Alan has a way of making high school and college bands sound really good. And there's a skill to it, the way they voice the chords. When you hear this chart, and I must admit, I bought this chart, and I didn't play it at all yesterday until 5 o'clock. I just passed it out at 5 o'clock, and they said, oh, that's kind of cool. I said, well, you want to do it? And they said, yeah. So this is the least rehearsed chart we've had. One, these are great players, but it also is a testimony to how a great arranger can really frame people and make them sound maybe older than they really are. So this has sort of three sections, kind of a solemn beginning, a very light and lively samba in the middle, and then back to that sort of solemn. And it really was commissioned by a high school in Ohio that had a young man pass away. And this sort of, I think, represents like a life well lived. So I hope you'll hear it in that regard. And Griffin Ross is going to play the tenor saxole, and Jacob Fleener, well known as Jack Fleener within the band. Thank you. I mispronounced his name for half the day, and nobody had the courage to tell me I was wrong. So it's Jacob, not Jack. So anyway, El Abrazo, Alan Baylock. Thank you. They learn the music so fast. So we'd like to finish with Mahler's Third Symphony. I've got some pizza coming in, so we'll be here a couple more hours. No, just kidding. They are so quick. I mean, this is almost a full-length concert they've learned in, 36 hours. Pretty amazing. So hats off to the directors and these students. Can you give them a hand? I'll share with you, I have a rather full day. So my daughter's in D.C. at the Million Women March. Yeah. Once Kenny broke the ice, I knew I could talk politically. And she's wearing a beanie cap that says, I'm the popular vote. Anyway, all being aside, so I've got sort of 1 foot praying that, you know, she's smart enough to just respectfully say what she has to say and not get in trouble. Then my grandson, I just got a text that his soapbox derby car won most beautiful car in the competition, and then I get to conduct this incredible band. So life is rich. We're going to switch over to, you know, when Essentially Ellington came out and Lincoln Center decided that they were going to make 14 to 18-year-olds try to sound like 50-year-old soloists who had been playing with Duke Ellington for 30 years, there was a bunch of us that thought, wouldn't basically Basie have been maybe a more intelligent decision? Because you don't have to quite have so many featured solos, so many, you know, it's like the Basie, you know, let me put it in the terms of Crayolas. Basie's like the 16 box. Ellington's like the 64 box. You know, he had to be able to play magenta, if you know what I mean, to play Ellington. So let's listen to what basically Basie sounds like. This is a 1960 piece written for the band by Benny Carter. It's part of a 9-movement suite called the Kansas City Suite. This one's called the Wiggle Walk. And we're going to have a few new solos, so I want to introduce them to you. Max Inman on trombone. You're going to hear Griffin again on tenor, Ben again on trumpet, Julian on piano again. So I guess Max, you're the only new one. But it'll be worth the wait. He's good.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for coming out. Not bad. This will be the longest one, sorry to say, but it's not Mauer Third. It's just John Coltrane's impressions. But there's so many good solos in this band. It's such a unique thing to have ensemble work, great rhythm section playing, and then all these solos. So I'm trying to get a few more to get a chance to showcase their talents. By the way, speaking of the word talent, I know Christmas is come and gone, but if you got some birthdays in 2017, I'd like you to buy a book. You can get it used on Amazon.com. It's called The Talent Code. And it basically says, talent isn't born, it's built. Okay, and they give some incredible examples, of which I'd love to talk to you about it, but the concert's gone long enough. But this is really pretty special stuff that's going on here, in my opinion. And it's just so great that so many of you are here to sort of acknowledge it. I was just thinking when these kids, the middle school kids, stood up, and my A band was up there cheering for them like it was a slam dunk contest. And I just, you know, I'm not sure that other athletes would be cheering for other athletes maybe quite as much. It's just a nice feeling of camaraderie in the room. I know all these directors and the students really took care of it. And I'm sure somewhere in the road, some band kid has gotten into trouble. But by and large, our kids don't get in trouble. They're working on their scales, their patterns, their arpeggios, their solos for contests. I got this student who got first chair in the concert band for the eighth grade, I guess that's middle school, and his mother's a little bit of a tiger mom, and she said, and now he's ready for the All-State, and then if he gets that, he's ready for the Nationals. And I said, well, I guess a little more pressure on the trumpet teacher here to help deliver that, but I kind of like that sense of the sky's the limit. Can you imagine somebody 18 years old? How old are you, Griffin? 17. I hate him even more. Only 7. I mean, he's probably, you know, what's that Malcolm Gladwell, you know, 10,000 hours to be excellent in anything? I think he's probably already there as a 17-year-old. He practices so much. So kudos to you that, you know, my wife is so good, she'll go, oh, you're going to practice? Okay, I'll go to the bedroom. And for every mother or father or son or daughter that says, oh, you know, Griffin wants to practice a little bit, well, let's let him have the big room. We'll go to the bedroom and watch TV. Thank you. So we'll close with impressions, and a whole slew of people will solo for you. For those of you that are interested in this thing, I don't know if you are or not, but it's a good teaching moment. This tune is different than every one we played so far in the fact that it's 32 measures, but it only has 2 scales. So any one of you could come up, and if you could just find a white key on the piano, you could play 24 bars of this 32-bar tune correctly. There's no bad note on that. Now, they'll do a lot more with it, but it's kind of a unique sort of style of playing. So it's just D minor for 16, E flat minor for 8, back to D minor for 8 bars. But what these kids do with it is pretty amazing. So, this is an arrangement by the master, Slide Hampton. Hope you enjoy it, and thanks for coming on a Saturday afternoon.
I'll go faster than that. Thank you.